My role at the ATSB is as one of our transport safety investigators, and I specialise in aviation human factors. It's difficult for some to understand how somebody with a lot of experience, say a pilot, has become involved in an accident, how their experience hasn't saved them. But by applying human factors principles, what we can do is try and explain not only what happened, but why, particularly in the context of the fact that the worst of accidents can happen to the best of people. We've often seen the media headlines saying pilot error was to blame. But what we try and focus on is the fact that errors are often consequences of other things rather than causes. So we might have a look at themes such as decision making, focus of attention, the role of workload, fatigue management, and a whole lot of other areas. So we build that into the analysis so that what we're doing is trying to explain why certain individual actions took place for the purpose of looking at how they can be prevented in the future. It's a well-known adage that you can't change the human condition, but the conditions in which humans work. So having a look at our strengths and our limitations, and particularly highlighting that with respect to an occurrence, helps us learn most accurately what has happened, why, and how to prevent it.